Hello friends, welcome to your channel Finoment. Today we will be discussing on mutual fund. Oh, wondering, I am saying mutual fund and showing the screen of ETF. Why it is so? So let me clear, this ETF are nothing but the mutual funds only. Because of the less popularity of the ETF, people don't invest, or lack of awareness, people don't invest in ETF. They are tend to get habituated with the mutual fund. So today I will be discussing the benefits of the ETF. But before that, why the name ETF is given? ETF means exchange traded fund. Since it is listed on both the exchanges, that is National Stock Exchange and Bombay Stock Exchange, where you can freely trade like any other stock, that's why it is traded. And it is mutual fund, that's why it is fund, that is exchange traded fund. Now we will be discussing one by one benefit, but before that let me clear that these ETFs are not for those who wants huge return in stock market and want to take risk. These are the very less risky as well as reasonable return you can expect from this ETF. Now just start with one first point: replicate the performance of the index, that is return you will get in this ETF will be as per the market. That is, if market up by 1-2%, you will get the 1-2% return. Of it is market down by 1-2%, you will lose just 1-2%. In stock, you can stock can rise up to 10%, 50%. Also chances that stock can fall up to 10%, 20%. So these are the less risky, which we have already discussed, and you will get a reasonable return, which is second point is also same as which we have discussed in continuation with the first point. Third point is you can buy and sell this ETF like any other stock easily with the good liquidity. Fourth point, you can buy and sell on real time basis. Market opens on the morning and close at the afternoon. You can during any time you can buy in the morning, sell at the evening, whatever you can do in stock, you can do here also in ETF. The fifth point is a good point is cost advantage. Here you don't have to incur expense ratio, only you have to pay brokerage, which normally broker charge is very negligible as compared to the expense ratio which we have to suffer in case of mutual fund. But first I would like to clear that for trading in ETF you need to have a account with the broker, then only you can trade in ETF. Then sixth point is no lock-in period and no exit load on sale of units, unlike mutual fund. In mutual fund, if you are going for ELSS, then in that case you have to your units gets lock-in for 3 years. Other than ELSS also, if you are withdrawing the money within 1 year, before 1 year, then in that case you have to pay a exit load, which is not in the case of ETF. You can buy in the morning, you can just sell in the 5 minutes, 10 minutes, whatever you want, you just sell it. You don't have to pay penalty for this ETF. So this, even though these are mutual fund, you don't have to do this exercise for the ETF. Then seventh point is minimum trading lot, just one unit. In this case you can buy a one unit also. If you are buying one unit, that means you are buying whole market, that is Nifty 50, 50 stock you are buying. So this is a positive point for this ETF. It provides a diversification for your portfolio. That is, if you are buying one unit, it means you are buying the, in one unit you are buying the 50 companies of Nifty, and if you are buying the Bank Nifty ETF, you are buying the whole basket of the Bank Nifty. The same in the case of mutual fund also, but here you can measure it is you can trade in ETF. That is also 9 point. That intraday is also possible, like stock in intraday you can buy, sell, again you can sell and buy, which is not easily available in mutual fund. Then 10th point also same, traded throughout the day better than mutual fund. In mutual fund you get the NAV only at the closing of the day, which is not in the case of ETF. You can trade n number of time in ETF. Here you will find a greater transparency in terms of investment portfolio. In mutual fund you have to thoroughly analyze that which mutual fund company are in investing in, which stock, which bonds, which debt, which cash, etc. But in case of mutual ETF, you know that if you are investing in Nifty 50, what are the Nifty 50 50s company, so easily you can identify. You don't have to study thoroughly. Then 12th most beneficial point is arbitrage or hedge in future market and cash market. If you are doing future and option, and if you are selling the option, and if your option gets in the money, in that case you can take the delivery of the ETF like stock. And if you are selling the call option, and in case your option gets in the money, in that case you can just give the delivery and square off your position. This is the most beneficial point of ETF. Now we'll just discuss the comparison of ETF versus the stock and ETF versus the mutual fund. These are the benefits only, but this is a just comparison what we have already discussed. First point is real time trading possible in ETF stock, which is not possible in mutual fund. Ability to put limit order, you can buy or sell the ETF at any price as you wish in stock also, but in mutual fund you have to pay the closing NAV, which will be calculated by the mutual fund company. Can be purchased through the NSE broker only on trading account. If you have a trading account you can buy and sell it, but in mutual fund you don't need a trading account. In stock also you need a trading account. It can be purchased or sell on real time basis, which is not possible in mutual fund, which is possible in ETF as well as in stock. Arbitration possible, just we have discussed in the last point, is possible in stock and ETF, not possible in mutual fund. Diversification possible, you can diversify portfolio and risk and return in ETF, but in stock also not possible. If you are buying a single particular stock, then in that case the complete portfolio will not come in your single stock. But in mutual fund it is possible, because mutual fund companies are investing in baskets of the stocks. Return you will get as per the market. Wherever the market is going, you will get the return as per the market. But in stock and mutual fund this point is not applicable. Intraday is possible in stock and ETF, whereas it is not possible in mutual fund. Paperless trading it is because you don't have to fill up any forms, KYC, which is we have to do in mutual fund. It is not possible, not applicable in ETF and stock. Exit load is applicable if you are withdrawing the money or redeeming the units before 1 year. In that case you have to pay the exit load. Guys, if you like our video, then if you want us to come up with various types of ETFs which you can invest in the market with good return and less risk, you just comment me in the comment or description comment box. So I'll bring up that video also, and just like our video, subscribe our channel and press the like button. Hope you enjoy the video.